All right there, how are we all doing? Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, wherever you are. This is Randomania 3, your home for all the randomizers, and week 5 of the Final Fantasy Randomizer Tournament. I believe we have 2 3-1 racers here, Ikbin Maya and Groggy Dog. So this is going to be a fun little race here. This is me, Game Boy F9. I'm joined by Sunny. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. Really excited to see this particular match. I've been trying to keep up with Groggy Dog. I've really liked what he's been doing.
Yeah, I don't know Groggy Dog all that well, but I'm about ready to let these runners loose here.
Well, doesn't look like it is a draft, so, I mean, that's something not to talk about is a draft.
No, it's not a draft. Okay, so Maya coming in with a rare thief. We haven't seen a thief very often in this tournament. And Groggy Dog doing the very traditional fighter red fighter and the rainbow mages. But we are about 5 seconds away from... No, never mind. The race has begun. And we all know how this is going to start off. It started off with a trip to the White Mage Shop. Cure 4 and Fade. Oh my goodness.
Well, you know, I didn't roll this one.
No, you don't. You didn't. That's our tracker MG Weirdo taking care of things. So, yeah, everybody's going to like that. Wow.
On the expensive side for those heels.
Yeah, the heels are a bit expensive. The tents are really cheap. Reroll for 2 whites and a black mage, says Cheesinator. Yeah, maybe. We see Maya going to try the imps. No, he just ran.
Oh, I wonder what kind of chaos Garland will have for us, because I have not yet had a seed where he's been easy.
Oh, chaos is never easy, is he? But first, we're going to check out the first few boxes and.
Unrunnable zombies. That's fun.
Yeah, zombies. Now, where are the plants? We need the plants.
Is there any place where there are both plants and zombies to fight?
Unfortunately, no. Not in this game. You'll have to go to a different game for that.
No, zombie and Ocho packs. That's probably for the best. They'd kill each other.
Maya's unlucky with a pickoff from the ghoul. And, oh, a loose adamant. Wow, we're one key item down already. Plus 6,000 money.
Wow. Okay, well, that kind of ruins my game. I usually like to play a game where I figure out how many times the dwarves have to be visited, but that already puts us down to, like, 3.
Alright, so, did Groggy just lose? Oh dear, Groggy just took a death there. As Maya knocks off Garland, he will take the early lead and level 3 for the party.
Most of the party. It looks like the fighter's taking a little bit of a nap there.
Oh, that's true.
Usually, yeah. I would expect the thief to be taking that nap, but, I mean, what can you do?
Yeah, I don't know. And we've got a key, so that opens up a whole bunch of boxes. And we also get the bottle. Whole lot of progression to start off this match.
I'll be honest with you, I was going to be just a little bit upset if Sarah had the TNT, because that would just mean one dwarf visit and no more.
TNT.
Don't start singing. We'll get copyright stricken.
We got 1,300 money on the right half of the castle, and a whole lot more. It's almost 6 grand on the other side, and a gold bracelet for 24 defense.
That seems pretty good at this point. I would not argue with the gold bracelet under any circumstance.
Oh, I like this strategy of seeing what weapons are for sale. Silver hammer for the white mage. You don't typically see that. And a long sword, you do typically see that. And a saber for the thief, as Groggy Dog defeats Garland.
There is one thing that's kind of bugging me about what Maya's doing, and that's the fighter is still down.
Well, he's equipping the fighter with stuff, so I'm guessing the fighter's going to come back in a minute, as soon as he finishes his business. And Groggy pauses upon seeing that gold bracelet, and okay, he continues on. See, Sonny? Called it! Called it!
Yeah, okay, I'll give you that. I was a little bit worried he was danning that fighter, and that would be just the weirdest thing I've seen.
Yeah, no. The only person I could think of that would do that would be Will Bloodworth, so...
So where did that term come from, anyway? Was it somebody named Dan who started doing that?
I think that's the story. I really don't know. All I know is that it's time to sail. That's the only thing I know. Oh, look what Maya's run into. He's run into sharks!
Nobody told me it was Shark Week.
Well, you're the second person to know. Okay, interesting strategy here by Maya, but I can see where he's going here. Picking up the 3 boxes in Matoya's cave, even though he doesn't have the crystal. The canal might be available here, so I totally get it.
I don't know, I would be more inclined to visit dwarves before Matoya. At least then you have a chance of picking up the crystal.
Yeah, I mean, you never know. The other loose item could be the crystal. We're going to find out here in a second. And we get the wizard's staff, the opal gauntlet, and 500 gold.
500 gold may sound like a lot, but with inflation, I mean, it's really just chump change.
Wow, a lot of really good spells here at level 2. Invis 2 to add 40 evasion to all members of the party and exit. And I saw Warp over in the Black Magic for level 2, so that's going to be beneficial for the for Castle Ordeals if it's required, and it typically is.
I don't think I've ever seen a particular seed where Ordeals wasn't required in some way, shape, or form.
All I know is that we have pirates falling on both sides. Well, Buccaneers more specifically over on Maya's side. We have an herb for Groggy Dog, which Maya is about to pick up in about 20 seconds.
Oh, that's why they were falling down.
There go the pirates, they're falling down. Oh, wait, you told me not to do that.
I think that one's public domain, that one's fine. Okay. I think I saw, was that a pro cape in the armor shop in Provoca?
A pro cape? I did not notice. If it was pro something, it would have been pro ring, because you can't get a pro cape in the armor store, if I'm not mistaken.
I thought I was tripping on something there for a second. But yeah, I saw pro something down there. Didn't see how much it was, but the fact that it exists is pretty good.
Totally understand Maya selling that wizard staff for 8,000 money. What it does is it casts Confuse on all the monsters, except it almost never hits, so... Except maybe Carrie.
I don't know. I've actually actively used it against Carrie once. It worked out wonderfully for me.
Yeah, exactly. Meanwhile, we have Grimps and Imps and a whole bunch of...
those. Yeah, okay, it was a pro ring for 29,000. That's a little bit pricey, but...
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, that's very expensive. That's for sure. But there are plenty of monsters that give away a whole bunch of gold, so...
Groggy Dog looking like he's heading to Elfland?
Yep, he's gonna probably, with his key in tow and his urban tow, gonna wake up the prince and gonna receive a bonus item. And that bonus item is the canoe. Well.
That could be very interesting, since we haven't exactly seen the canal. We haven't seen Marsh either, where the canal usually lives at this point. But if we find the floater, we might not need a canal.
Yeah, I mean, we'll find out here in a moment, but another 1,000 money, and Groggy Dog's first weapon of the game, or, no, that's not true, he sold some weapons, but yeah, Ice 3 and Lock 2 for our Black Magic, and Groggy Dog going to town here as Maya goes to level 5.
Hey, we can't discount the cake. That particular spell saved my butt so many times.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Life spell for Groggy Dog. And he's going to pick up Cure 2, because why not?
Personally, I think I'd pick up Harm. But, I mean, that's just because I like having a Harm spell and I rarely find the Light Axe.
Yeah, trying to get a little offense going for the White Wizard. The fast spell at level 4, man, everything's coming up aces here for our runners in the spell department.
Why can't I get this kind of seed? I never get this kind of seed.
I don't know, I can't answer that question.
All my seeds are like fast at level 5 or level 7. I don't get to touch it because I'm a... Oh, Oxy Ale in the shop for 54,000.
Yeah, that's expensive. Groggy Dog had to pause there for a moment. Love the strategy, exiting out of the town to save a few seconds, because you never know.
I did not know you could do that. I didn't know towns counted enough as dungeons to just be able to exit or warp out.
Yeah, anything's a location that you can exit out.
Looks like Maya's the first to the dwarves, turning in the adamant for a crown. That is a very durable crown.
Yeah, and as a matter of fact, that'll result in some pretty optimal routing for him. He'll be able to go straight to the Astos castle here in a minute. He did not turn in the TNT?
Did he find the TNT?
Oh,
I don't think we've
no.
got the TNT just yet. That was a max gold chest, though, so suddenly that Oxy Ale is looking a lot more attractive.
Yeah, right? Well, where did the TNT go?
We mentioned the TNT, but we didn't actually see it yet. I think Sarah had the bottle, so that's what I was about to be griping about. If she happened to be holding the TNT and just meet it, so you only have to go to dwarves once.
Groggy Dog really trying to. Oh, I'm sorry, Groggy Dog trying to equip the heal helmet. And unfortunately, only the knight can equip that.
And this has been the Sunny Learns One Thing a Day moment.
All right, we're about to have one dead elf here. One dead dark elf. Let's be more accurate.
It looks like Astos was playing dice just about a minute ago and then lost a bet.
Yeah, that was a very unfortunate result for Astos, but a very happy result for Groggy Dog, advancing him to level 6, I believe.
And then Groggy Dog goes to check Astos' shed.
Yeah, it makes perfect sense. And there's also two possible grind fights. There are two little spike tiles to check out. Not a lot in the boxes. Oh, 4 gammas. Oh my goodness.
And with Ice 3, that seems like a pretty dang good place to grind.
Well, when he gets some Ice 3 charges, but he'll get them pretty soon if at this rate.
Problem is, fire doesn't seem to do much to these little critters.
Oh, and worse, they have high hit points, and we have a swoon fighter here. While Maya is going after a couple blue dragons at the Temple of Fiends. He's going to pass on that, but he might have to come back to that later on.
So, I know there's gas dragons, there's the red dragons, white frost dragons, blue dragons. I'm guessing that based off elemental properties, the blue dragons might be normally lightning?
I think so. Not too sure. But Maya did come back, pick up a silver helmet, so in that bottom right room.
At least they're not unrunnable.
Exactly. And the Cerebuses are a little bit better as a first grind spot. Ice 3 should take care of them pretty good. Yeah, there they go. That'll really help his cause. Level 7 for the team. House and an opal shield. Yeah, he's gonna bail out of that, save a few seconds, and probably gonna visit the castle now.
That seems like a reasonable thing to do, but what do you do after that, I wonder?
Yeah, no canal found quite yet, so I'm guessing it's going to be a trip to the volcano. Maybe they'll go to the Marsh Cave because they're in the area.
Groggy does have the canoe, so that is... Wait, what? Did something just say hi, Mom, on Groggy Dog's side? What did I just miss?
No, I missed it.
What did Groggy Dog talk to that said hi, Mom? Somebody tell us in chat.
I don't know. Oof, 4 scorpions. Wow.
4 scorpions and 7 years ago.
Yeah, sure. Alright. Oh. And so the fairy's been popped over on Groggy Dog's side, and he is going to check out the Marsh Cave. So here we go. We'll see if this pays off.
Here's hoping he doesn't forget about that bottle.
So Maya picks up the item over in Elfland, and we see that he has A0 heal potions.
I'm sorry, you just made my brain crash for just a hot second there. What was that?
You know what? My brain crashed too. So, Groggy Dog's gonna check out the first 4 boxes. A pro cape! That's not a bad prize, and he's got exit, so... Oh, but crawls with cremate. That's not so great.
Yeah, I have not yet met marsh that I've really liked.
Well,
Blaze from the crawls.
Yeah, that's hopefully he just reset and try that again. Well, Maya's gonna go ahead and equip some stuff here. Upgrade with silver armor for the fighter. Hmm. Yeah, Groggy Dog definitely wants his pro cape, but I think he powered off and back on because he's dealing with this team again and gets away this time.
I've seen that happen so many times here recently where it's just the same encounter over and over in the table. It is so, so bad.
Yeah. We got
like a
Yes. So if Maya goes this direction, that's going to be pretty good for his thief.
For Groggy, I believe it just happens to be a sword-shaped pile of gold.
Exactly. So now that Groggy's checked out the north part of the cave, he's gonna check out the south part of the cave.
At least they have the key, so they don't have to stop and wonder, oh crap, what if my items is key-locked in Marsh? They can just go check that out right away.
Mm-hmm. Let's see, Maya is headed toward that direction, if I'm not mistaken. Now we do have a few boxes to check out here. Oh, there's the canal, and his gamble pays off.
Yeah, usual spot for a canal from what I've seen. It usually likes to live in that particular chest.
Ooh, look what Maya's doing. It turns out... Oh no, he's going to pick up some... You know, pick up those three boxes and then he's going to bail out. So it's not even going to bother. I thought he was going to do some grinding. Well, maybe he still is going to do some grinding. Oh no, he's going to fight Astos and get the cube. There we go. Stinger is such an annoying ability from the ogres. It's mostly just a time drain because you gotta pure everybody, but still.
It can also be pretty devastating early if the purers happen to be on the expensive side and you just can't get that gold. Well, fortunately, in this case, that's not what happened, but I've seen things like purers and softs go for over 1,000.
Ooh, and a max price katana for another 30 grand. My goodness.
Yeah, all that stuff about needing gold, I just said, forget it.
Yeah. Well, we got a couple characters asleep over on Maya's side. Gonna trying his hand on Caribs and Gators. And the thief falls flat again.
That might have been done on purpose, since that thief is hanging out in the first slot. I'm not sure if he's banning the thief or just had him there to run. It looks like it was a purposeful thing, since they swapped the fighter right back to the front.
Yeah, that'll do it. Alright, so it looks like he's heading over to Crescent Lake. Definitely makes sense. Gonna go ahead and pick up the free item that he's gonna pick up there. Sorry. I was like, oh no! No, it's Groggy Dog that's gonna pick up the Oxy Ale for an extra 5% experience.
Can't hardly argue with the extra experience and the fact that it does open up the Sea Shrine. I mean, I don't know anybody who really likes diving in there just to check for a loose item, but it's open.
Hey, what the hey? Life 2 over in level 6. So that's a little bit of Temper, also a bit of an at level 6 for on the black magic side. And the item we're going to claim is the Chime.
Oh, so the sages were a bunch of partners in Chime today.
There you go. Let's see, so that means he's got access to the Mirage Tower. So, if he needs something important, it could be there. Looks like Groggy Dog's gonna do some grinding here. That's what I'm seeing as Maya goes to level 8 for the team.
If Groggy Dog picked up any charges for that ice too, it makes sense.
Yep. That's what happened. Ooh, nice hit by the
fighter. Ice 3.
Yeah, Ice 3.
I wouldn't do that with Ice 2. It's just not strong enough.
See, and right there, that was 2,000 points and pretty much a cost of a house.
Man, wouldn't that be nice? You just go out, beat up some monsters, and then suddenly you can afford a house.
I know, right? Unfortunately, the houses disappear after a night. What's that all about?
They're made of cardboard and it rains every night.
Well, I'll tell you what you don't want raining is toxic fumes from X-Peds. So Maya will not be fighting those anytime soon.
So, do we reckon that there's going to be the other loose item somewhere in Volcano? I love the chest density, just how many there are right there.
Yeah. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of runners really like that. And already, Maya's picked up 30,000 gold here, which is a lot. Oh, and a Zeus Gauntlet. That also is very helpful. Every use of that is a lit too. And there's the other loose item, the crystal.
Does that count as a commentator's blessing?
Yeah. Yep. Also a pro ring on top of that for 8 defense and death immunity for one player. Well, not immunity, but resistance, I should say.
Like, the only thing that could make that better is if the Masa is also somewhere in Volcano.
Meanwhile, some Argoyles going down for 600 points. While Groggy Dog knocks out some Ruru's, and R and Kylo adds the spike tile there over in
yep.
Volcano.
I would nope out of there too. I do not like those things.
No, they're just so not worth it. I noticed a level 5 nuke. Over on Groggy Dog's side, excuse me.
Anything below level 6 is a pretty good place for Fade or Nuke, as far as I'm concerned.
Unlucky pickoff here by over on Maya's side, and oof, wow, some close calls here. As he's got to revive the Black Mage. Now he's got to do a whole lot of healing with that heal potion in a suboptimal menu spot.
That's slightly suboptimal menuing at all, because you could just do up and left to get the heal potions.
Yeah, that's true. Wow, Maya's reporting directly to, I'm guessing, the Agama spike tile. I really don't see him going after Carrie at this point.
I mean, it's possible, but not probable. The fact that he's kind of ignoring all of these other side rooms, not even checking chests. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. Actually, I think I know what he's going for. He's going for the incentive tile over in the fire volcano. It is fire week, so.
Oh, there we go. But still, it makes sense that he'd be bypassing all of those other chests because he's found both of his loose items, so he knows there's nothing super relevant in there. But potentially missing out on ribbons, Moss Moon, Excalibur, and countless other really useful things.
Yeah, pretty bold strategy here, but we'll see if it works out as Groggy Dog picks up his chime over in Crescent City. Crescent Lake, excuse me. That's a different game.
I don't know, I mean, it works out all the same, right?
Sure.
I just call it Crescent, call it a day. Some grimps guarding the incentive chest.
I know, that's so interesting. There's the TNT. Now, Groggy Dog might go all the way to carry here. He is on a significantly higher level than Maya, so we'll see how this all works out here.
In Groggy Dog's position, I can't see any reason not to.
I do see a reason for him to reset Scorpions with Crack. Means a nice big earthquake shows up and consumes, like, everybody.
At least it's not lobsters with Crack.
Alright, now Groggy Dog picking up a whole lot of money here.
We're gonna find his Zeus Gauntlet and the crystal, that's always helpful. If you're these racers, do you go back to Matoya and turn in that crystal real quick?
That looks like what Maya's doing, and I figure, you might as well. No, that's not what he's doing. He's going to turn in the TNT. I hope he remembers that he has the crystal.
I mean, they're both inner sea turn-ins, so, I mean, once you've done those, there's really not much reason to go back to inner sea except to pick up magic after you promote.
And now Groggy getting the bad news of Toxic from the Peds.
And these are some pretty beefy Peds, too.
Yeah. And it's a power gauntlet for the TNT, so, I mean, that'll be helpful, but maybe not exactly what he wanted right now.
I always like to figure out how the heck that works. And the only thing I can figure is that Nerik loaded up the TNT into the gauntlet, and that's what powers you up. Whenever you swing, a stick of TNT goes off and helps you out.
Yeah, I like that explanation.
So we got a crown made of adamant and a TNT-powered power bonk.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, I don't know if he wanted to check out that spike tile. With those red and Kylos, and he's not getting away either. Oh no, now he does.
Oh man, those things are worse than I thought. They were one shot the white mage and have stun touch, paralyze. I mean, they knock the fighter for a loop just on contact.
Yep, exactly. And since the white mage was eliminated, he couldn't revive, so he decided to hit that reset button.
You know, they say you never forget your first time. I remember my first time encountering this particular encounter with the giants and iguanas. Everything could turn my party to stone. So I get nervous seeing those.
That's what we call evil. Evil.
The crystal. Crystal turned into the opal Cheerio. So that's what you call whammy items, I guess.
Yeah, once again, a helpful item, but probably not what he was looking for right now.
Let's see, what's the explanation for that one? Matoya is not really blind. The crystal was just the last piece she needed for that little arts and crafts project, and she handed the results over.
Oh, yeah, you're right. All right, Groggy Dog picking up his crystal.
Not knowing that it's not worth as much as he'd like it to be yet. But that pro ring probably is. Totally forgot there was a pro ring there.
Alright, Maya coming back to pick up some supplies. 10 houses? That's over in Corneria he did that in.
Oh, Vorpal Sword that Maya didn't get.
Oh, wowie, wowie, wow. And he gets away from the Ankylos. So the Vorpal Sword, not as strong as the Master Mune or the Excalibur, but a number of runners like to use that sword because of that high critical rate.
It's hard to argue with a critical. It ignores a really good chunk of an enemy's absorb. I wonder if Groggy Dog's going to check the rest of the chests in those hairpins. Probably not.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it. He's gonna check out some other things. Now, I believe all he has to do, because he's picked up both items, obviously. We picked up the adamant and the crystal. He just has to check out incentivized items, figure out where everything is. And find the canal, probably. Oh no, wait a minute, he found the canal. Maya needs to find the canal in the marsh cave.
It's still entirely possible that canal doesn't ever need to be touched. The floater could still be in a really convenient spot.
Well, the only place the floater can be in at this point is the ice cave in this... Maya wants his dream come true, so to speak.
Well, I mean, ice cave's not a super bad option as long as you have a cast of warp. You can just get in, get your item, and get out.
Looks like that's what Maya's gonna try here, and...
You know, I think we're too good at this. We keep predicting what they're gonna do before they do it.
Hey, there's our buddy, the Gray W. Oof, 29 damage. That is not going to be helpful.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I swear whoever named that thing was colorblind.
I like what Maya's doing. Doing the fade on the cockatrices and the mummy for 1,000 points. The cockatrices are typically so weak, especially without their special ability, but... Oh, I just noticed an ice sword on Groggy Dog's side.
Gotta like seeing one of those. Especially with all the normally fire dungeon things that hang out, and heading up to carry to begin with. I think it's just encouragement to go do carry.
Did Groggy just slip into the spike tile there, those two wizard ogres?
I look like it.
Yeah.
I don't know if that was just him getting in a hurry or what. Ignoring that third chest, I guess that's a linked chest?
Yes, that is correct. That is a linked chest, so he doesn't have to worry about opening that. He might want to worry about that Agama, though.
Not to bring another game into this, but that Agama is a Gamma gone.
Alright, Groggy's starting to run out of heal potions, but I think he'll have enough to get the incentivized item, and then he'll have a decision to make. Zombuls is a spike tile.
That's wonderful. You normally see those at the Peninsula of Power, though, wouldn't you? So, I mean, this isn't a super bad thing.
Yeah, especially when they don't have a lot of HP. Oh, that's going to be like 2,000 points. Yeah, almost.
Can't hardly argue with that. They go down like a ton of bricks.
Alright, here's that excellent play with that warp spell. 7,000 money. There's the floater, and his gamble pays off! He doesn't have to go through marsh!
Yeah, that canal is completely not needed. Which, I mean, that's the second time I've seen that.
Wow, what a play! Meanwhile, everybody's asking, is this even randomized? And the answer is, yes it is. Just happened to wind up that way.
Well, the enemy placements are randomized anyway. I'm not sure about the items anymore.
The only thing I know is that there are 4 more zombies on the floor.
So what you're saying is there's a bunch of ground beef there?
Maybe. I wouldn't want to eat it, though. I tell you what, though, Groggy really likes his zombies.
I mean, I would too, because it's Peninsula of Power. Without being Peninsula of Power, you don't have to go out of your way to find those. They just come to you.
Yeah, I mean, how many points has he scored off of this? Like, approaching 6,000? That's a lot. That's a lot of points.
1,800 and change for a 4-pack, so... I don't know, they are pretty worth it. And those Ogres with Stinger again. That just sucks all the way around.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I believe he's beaten 13 Zombuls, so yeah, that's about 6,000 experience points. Very, very well done. Now, understandably so, he's going to try carry out. I think he's going to be in a very good position to win.
Ice 3 and Ice Sword. Yeah, I think he's probably got a pretty good edge.
But Maya is off into the air. He's going to pick up a free item here over in Sardius Cave.
Now, I was hearing something the other day about Sardi having a tail, which he just cut off and gave to the party. But I heard that Sardi was considered ruby-locked for most seeds. Is that accurate?
Yeah, that is accurate. That is how you would get that go wrap around, so to speak, is by getting the floater. Meanwhile, Groggy Dog doing some pretty good work here. With this carry, slowly but surely, carry going against the grain and casting ice too.
I mean, she's just chilling out, right?
Oh my goodness, that was a minimum damage fade. Oh my gosh, 80 damage—that's as low as it gets. And will Carrie go down anytime soon? She's just been chipped down. Now there's a more appropriate fire too.
Back on Maya's side, kind of realizing that finding that tail from Sardia and the floater means, hey, promotion is in the immediate future. That fighter can probably get all of his spell slots.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea to go ahead and promote. There isn't a black belt hanging out or anything like that, so he's free to do so. Gonna pick up some boxes for free while we're at it, but nothing too out of hand here, as Groggy knocks out Carrie, so he will take the early 1-0 orb lead. His next decision is going to be very important, and he's heading down toward Crescent Lake instead of the ice cave, although that might be understandable with only 20 heal potions left.
Yeah, with only 20 of them, I would definitely think a shopping trip is well in order. Also, reviving party members, that's also important.
Yeah, that's right, good point. Yep, time to heal up, and it's time for Maya to promote. Burp, burp, burp.
Always kind of wondered why the heck the King of Dragons decides that a rat tail is an appropriate signifier of your courage.
You know, I have no idea, but I mean, in Final Fantasy 1, you just meet Bahamut. You don't even have to beat him up or anything like that. Now the later Final Fantasies, oh boy, watch out.
How many different varieties of Bahamut are there in later Final Fantasies? There's at least 3 in one game.
Yeah, once again, a whole lot of nothing in the Cardia Isles here.
I like to call them the Charizard Islands or the Charizardia Islands.
Yeah.
It's full of Charizards.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, I think I know why Maya's going to this town. The name of which eludes me right now, but...
Gaia.
Gaia, thank you.
Nothing worthwhile in the magic shop. It looks like that particular town is going to be completely worthless for magic.
No, yeah, you're right. It's going to be completely worthless, but there is one important thing here.
Yeah, Maya's certainly remembering that bottle, but if we recall, Groggy Dog already popped his bottle, so he's actually going to have to remember that fairy is there.
Yeah, and it is required. The loot is available over at the fairy spot.
Yeah, quick hooray!
Hooray! Groggy, understandably, turning in the TNT to pick up that power gauntlet. Not going to be very happy about that, but it is what it is.
I don't know anybody who's not happy to see the power bonk if they've got a fighter involved.
Well, yeah, true. I mean, but it's not like the floater, for example.
That's true enough. I'll give you that. But, like, I'd still rather see the power bonk over, like, the Opal Cheerio or Thor.
Yeah, sure, sure. The power gauntlet not only raises attack power for the user, but also the hit rate.
Now that's something I didn't know. I just thought it made you a little bit more beefy in how you swung.
Yeah, it's actually better than the temper spell.
Ooh, Maya making a quick trip into the ordeals. That's gonna be fun and annoying.
Yeah, so, but fortunately, I believe he's got war, but Medusas have damage poison! Oh my goodness! Oh, get away from those Medusas! Gracious!
And unrunnable mancats! Because why not, right?
Yeah, right? Yeah, nice little Fade takes care of him, though. Another 1,000 points, he'll take it. Now, these pillars are randomized here in Castle Ordeals, and there's a good reason for that. It rewards people who bring the warp spell with them. Oh no, not these again. Oh boy, I think... Oh? Yeah, I cannot see Maya continuing. Nope. Takes the reset.
Those Medusas are gonna suck without a ribbon.
Yeah, I know, right?
So, any bets that there's a ribbon at the end of Castle of Ordeals?
Well, there won't be a ribbon at the end. Well, there could be in one of those 11 boxes. We'll see, but looks like Groggy Dog's heading toward that same area.
Which is just slightly unfortunate, because we know that if he wants to get around quickly, he really wants to go to Ice Cave.
Yeah. Although at the same time, I mean, maybe you'll find stuff to where you don't have to bother with getting the floater.
We already know the floater is required, because the fairy has the loot, and you can't get to Gaia without the floater.
And there is an excellent use of the warp spell right there by making an incorrect choice but able to use that warp spell to go back to where he was.
I know there's someone out there who still has horrible flashbacks about these sorcerers.
Is that you?
No, I was just tracking that game. I've tracked a game where these sorcerers decided to have nuke.
Ah! Well, it doesn't look like these sorcerers have nuke. It looks like they're just hitting, so they'll gladly take the experience for that. I saw 2600 for Maya that fight.
That is nothing to shake your stick at there. Unless your stick happens to catch fire, too.
Yeah. Oh, I think... Well, geez, both of our runners are getting lost through here.
Yeah, I hate it when the correct pillar is that fourth one, because it's so far away.
And it looks like that's the case today.
Fortunately, once you get past that one, the rest of the chain is pretty easy.
There we go. Maya's through, and... We'll have a spike tile fight coming up once he takes care of these Argoyles. And Groggy's through! And the spike tile is a giant in iguana. Oh boy. Oh, four giants over Groggy's Groggy's side, and he will accept it. Well, he might not anymore, not with Lit 2.
Yeah, that's a little bit scary when you got four of those suckers throwing Lit 2 all over you. At least there's not a boss at the end of this.
And they are very high HP.
Meanwhile, Maya finding a pack of mummies, which can't hardly argue with that.
Oof. Groggy breaks through for 2,000 points.
I would rather that mummy tile, that slab at the end of the Temple of Ordeals, Castle Ordeals, the Ordeals Land. You want deals? We got deals. We got Ordeals. Lost snow for your canoe? We got Ordeals.
Yeah, now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, he has to get the float. Yeah, Groggy must get the floater from the ice cave because the fairy in Gaia had the loot. But there's the slab for Groggy Dog. He will go back on his ship in just a moment.
Now, it looks like from our wonderful track weirdo's work here, we only have two more key items to grab for. So one of them's got to be behind the slab, and one of them's got to be behind the... And when I say key items, I include the Thor hammer, because why not? But one of them's got to be behind the slab, one of them's got to be behind the ruby. If it's behind the slab, you don't have to worry about the ruby anymore.
That's right, I believe we just have to... It looks like both runners are still looking for a rod, so... We have level 5 wall. I did not notice that before. And there's the nuke. Maya's going to be very happy to see that.
Croggy Dog getting the business end of these Gurmedusas. Stone, stun, heat. This is not any 14 hits from these things too? Wow.
And damage poison too. Whoa.
I'm
Don't
really
heal,
surprised.
Just fade and get on with it. Get on with life.
Yeah, I'm really kind of surprised Groggy doesn't just, like, reset out of this, because this is not a fight you want to put up with for any length of time.
Oh, he doesn't have fate anymore. I understand why he did that now. And down he goes. Oh.
Gurmedusas, very tired of being used for experience. They are fighting back.
Alright, Maya is going to hang out and head on over to Lufenia to learn a little Lufenian. Or, talking Lufenian. That's what I was going to say.
You got to practice it or you get rusty.
Yeah, I know, right? There's the ruby.
There's the ruby, yeah. Oh, jeez. Okay, so... That's interesting. I wouldn't have thought that the ruby would be behind the slab. Because somewhere out there, there's a Thor, and somewhere out there, there's a rod.
Yep, so it's either going to be behind the ruby, and the Titan will happily go crunch, crunch, crunch. Or...
That's right, the robot's a thing.
Yeah, he'll have to go to the waterfall cave.
Now, for everything I've run, I always try very hard to prioritize waterfall because it seems like such an easy place to check. It's relatively straightforward, not a lot of pitfalls to worry about. Just get in, talk to the robot, and get out.
Ooh, this is kind of unlucky here by Groggy Dog. He reset. That's what happened. Never mind.
Yeah, those Gurmedusas gave him the business.
No, it was just Medusa's this time. He got hit with a couple doses of damage poison.
You know what? Just Medusa's in general. They are not putting up with it anymore. They are fighting back.
6,000 money and a Thor hammer. That was at the Titan's corner, so that means he'll have to go to the waterfall. And then after he goes to the waterfall, he will be in go mode. He'll probably... head on over to Onrek to tackle the water shrine.
That seems entirely reasonable, like, of all the shrines, the Sea Shrine is my least favorite, just in general. The Mirage Tower at least has a really high density of chests, so it's a pretty good place to go even if you don't have the cube. Earth is at least early enough that Lich is generally just a speed bump, and as I say that, though, I've seen a couple of games where Lich is just also tired of being pushed around.
Yeah, right?
Turns out Lich is actually supposed to be a boss.
Alright, so Maya went ahead and did a little Maya and Gator shopping there, and now he's gonna do some Red Caribe and Frost Gator shopping. I'm gonna knock out those Caribes very quickly, and there goes the Gator, and that'll be worth some serious points.
It's my understanding that Gator is actually pretty tasty too, so I mean, if you're gonna go shopping for meat, Gator's the way to go.
Yeah. I've never tried Gator meat. Have you tried Gas Dragon meat, though?
I mean, I really can't without some Gas X. The timing of that joke is perfect, because he killed it with a Quad X.
Alright, now Groggy really needs to cast Exit, and he will. We'll figure out what his next destination is in a moment. Maya's still going through the waterfall, and understandably so, taking on some fights along the way.
Now, Groggy's options are actually severely limited compared to Maya's, because Groggy hasn't found the floater yet, which means the ferry is still locked away, Loopa Loopa Land is still locked away. He could go pay a visit to Sardia and get his tail, but that doesn't do him any good until he gets the floater from Ice Cave.
Correct.
Nachos with creamy, those are some hot nachos.
Oh, and there's a hot fight with two fighters. That's going to be worth a heck of a lot of experience here.
Does everything know cremate?
I crash cremate. I know cremate. Everybody knows cremate. Oh, and they knows Blaze too. My God.
Oh, didn't we see this exact spell skill list from something else a minute ago?
Yeah, we did. Yeah, it was a few minutes ago, but yeah, and down he goes. Oh, that's so unfortunate.
What was it that had the cremate and Blaze earlier? I can't remember.
I don't remember off the top of my head, but I definitely saw that skill set before. All I know is we have nightmares on one side and perilous on the other. I'm a bit scared.
You know, I've come to nicknaming those nightmares Pestilence, purely because of a quote from a book. And I'm pretty sure it wasn't the Bible, but it was trying to quote the Bible. It says, I saw a pale horse, and on that horse was a pale rider. The horse's name is Pestilence, and the rider's name is Death. So the pairing of nightmare and bad man is Pestilence and Death.
All right, Groggy Dog now going to take a crack here at the, well, not quite. Thought about going after those Mudgoals, but decided not to. I believe we are virtually tied in experience. I think both sides are about level 17.
The big difference is that Maya's been three-manning and Groggy Dog still had all four of his party members up. Okay, in these chests, a white shirt.
Yeah, white shirt. Just as good as the gold bracelet defense-wise, but it also gains some protection and also casts Invis 2 for free. Oh, he's tempting fate by going after more of these fighters.
Maya found a second katana, so probably didn't need that first one. But there was also something else relatively interesting in there that I had seen. There's a power stick and got something else that was really useful. I already forgot what it was.
This is not looking good for... Well, never mind. I thought he was running out of nuke charges, but it looks like he has three of them. Wow. 9,075 points, and he wants more. Oh, boy. He has no idea. I bet he does now.
Tracker Weirdo, remind me, that was a sun sword that was found, so that's probably going to end up being relatively useful.
Oh, ho, Groggy Dog barely gets out of that, so he now has 12,100 experience on the line. There's the rod.
Now, does Groggy Dog check the rest of the chests? Yes, he does.
Yep. There's the sun sword, and there's another katana. Get out of there! Sun sword being the best sword a knight can equip, if I'm not mistaken.
Best sword a fighter can equip. A knight can obviously get Excalibur.
You're right, excuse me. That's what I meant, the fighter.
And even then, that's not even true, because obviously every class can equip the Mass Moon.
Yeah. Details. Everybody can equip the Moss Immune. Even I can equip the Moss Immune. Ooh, the lobsters have some HP. Well, not too much, though.
Some HP, but not enough to keep them from being turned into lobster beast.
So level 18 now from Maya. He doesn't have a lot of levels to go. Maybe about 6 or so. I mean, we'll see how he plays it. But he wants more sea trolls and lobsters.
As long as they avoid those sea snacks, I've never seen anything good come from those.
I know, right? So very quickly, Maya's already got 5,000 experience out of those two battles, so nice one.
So there is one slight tiny hang-up that these runners might be having right now, and that's the utter lack of ribbons so far.
Well...
Defense sword, though, I mean, there's that.
Oh!
Speak of the devil and he shall appear.
Oh boy, everybody's gonna want you for commentary now, Sonny.
Yeah, I keep saying things and then they show up. I mean, if that is my power, then so be it.
The defense sword, it casts I forget what the exact spell is, but that raises the user's invasion by 80. So all you need is 3 casts of that, and you are pretty much immune to any monster's attack.
Really? It increases evasion? I thought it increased absorb.
No, it's evasion. Twice as much as the white shirt, but only for one user.
In that case, I imagine it's like a super invis. That might take some researching.
2,000 more points for Maya, thanks to some more sea trolls and lobsters. Ooh, Groggy Dog skipping the Sharknado room there, and so he will be without a ribbon there.
Well, there are still 2 more ribbons somewhere. Where they are, we don't know. We might never know.
We'd like to thank our tracker, MG Weirdo, for helping us out there. It's Ruse that was the spell I was thinking of. But yeah, Fog increases Absorb, and Fog 2 increases Absorb for the entire party. I think that's how that works. I don't have my cheat sheet with me. Great play, starting off with the Defense Sword over on Maya's side, followed by a Nuke for very low damage, 150. Fade isn't much better, 145. Oop, well, that was a very competitive fight by the Kraken. Kraken should be very disappointed with his performance.
From what I've seen, if a Kraken is not, if a Kraken ain't packing, he will become Topher.
Oh, there we go. 267 damage to knock out the Black Mage.
I mean, is that really a feat, though, knocking out a Black Mage?
Well, I don't know. Although, I'll tell you what, it doesn't have nuke charges anymore.
Oh, Dark on the fighter, that can't be happy.
No, I know, right? Oh, by the way, Dark doesn't do anything.
Oh, really? It just kind of sits there and makes him look cool, all dark and edgy?
Yeah, it just changes his status to Dark.
Here I thought it might have lowered accuracy.
No, I don't believe it does. Unless they fixed that. I don't think they have. Alright.
I mean, they fixed so many other things.
So now Groggy Dog has a one orb advantage, but Maya has the required floater. I mean, Groggy's got to go all the way back to the ice cave to pick it up.
Let's see here. From a little bit of research, the dark status, what it's supposed to do is decrease your hit rate by 40, increase an enemy's hit rate against that target by 40. Which, that's kind of no bueno.
Yeah. Groggy decides that shark isn't sticking around. Knocks it out for 100 points. Oh,
there does kind of come a point where if it's just a single enemy and you know it's nothing, it's just faster to hold A instead of doing the extra menuing to run.
Meanwhile, we saw Maya knock out 3 out of the 4 Cerebuses and then runs. Don't you hate it when that happens?
Yeah, I've gotten to the point where if I'm going to run, there's really not a whole lot of point in casting anything else. Just wastes the charge.
Well, there's a very interesting spike tile there. Shadows. Okay, looks like Groggy is going to head over to the ice cave, so you'll need to hurry it up because Maya's about to even the score as far as the orbs are concerned. But, oh, look what we have. We have 2 green Medusas, and now he's stunlocked. Oh my goodness. But he's gonna hang on until they cast Blaze, or Damage Poison, excuse me. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, Groggy Dog knows exactly how dangerous these green Medusas are. Maya's just now getting the first taste of it, I think.
Yeah, this might be an argument to bring back his ninja at this point. I think he's going to need that 4th character just so he gets some run power.
I mean, he does have a katana, so there's no real reason not to have the ninja, really, except for maybe lowering the experience the rest of his party gets, but the rest of his party is pretty decently beefy at this point.
Yeah. Groggy Dog just still going down the ice cave. Looking to take on that Frost Dragon. Frosty D is what I like to call it. It's a good DJ name.
Yeah, I could see that. You almost have to have a sprite of the Frost Dragon as your insignia, though.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Shadows with Blizzard. Whoa. All right, now it's time to heal up and hope he doesn't get unlucky here.
Groggy Dog finally going to get his floater. We still don't know what else might be in Ice Cave. I learned very, very quickly that these like 6 or so chests that are down there in the bottom, not to be discounted.
Yeah, and it looks like he might do some exploration here, so we'll see what pops up here, but the clock's kind of running here. Because Maya's up to the 2nd floor already of the floating castle.
Maya is very much in go mode and is showing, but at the same time, Groggy Dog does still have a one orb lead. That's not going to last very long at this point, but it does exist, so he might be feeling a little bit comfortable.
Alright, Maya's going to knock out three more mana cores for a total of seven, so he's got 7,000 points on this journey already. And change. Wow. Now that is a grind spot. Three mages and a fighter? Oof. $3,500 experience there, so... Now he's going to go down the Hall of Destiny with that 24 and 250. Oh, it's Warmech in 12,000 experiences. He's putting 12,000 experience on the line. All right. Oh, no, he ran. Aw. I can't blame him. I can't blame him. That's a lot of experience to put on the line. He'd lose a lot of time, too, if he failed. So totally understandable.
Over on Groggy Dog's side, he did visit that sixth chest room in Ice Cave. I saw a Weresword and a Bane Sword. I didn't see what else he pulled, but that Bane Sword could potentially come in handy.
It can come in handy with Tiamat, because I know a lot of people really like to throw that Bane Sword against Tiamat, so you know, we'll see how that works out.
To this day, every time I've faced Kraken, it's just been... Brack, and that's been it, so I'm not opposed to Bane Sword strats.
Alright, Maya must put his 10,500 experience on the line, but I don't think this is going to be too bad, except, wow, that was a poor fade. Well, Nuke's going to take care of that. 5,000 experience, whew!
Three more chests for Groggy, just pulling out that that heel helm and some pocket change. Really, barely even pocket change. That's couch change.
Yeah. All right, Tiamat time. And we'll see if she's got anything interesting going on here. We're going to start off with a power gauntlet, and then we're going to throw a wall down to... give him ribbon for the battle. And then what is he gonna do? Wants to make sure he gets a nuke off. 8 hits, 152 damage. 4 hits, 116 in reply from Tiamat. So looks like Maya's looking real good here. Another 300 damage, 400 damage now when you count the fade, and the quad X is enough and he's gone. So Maya is going to take his 19,000 experience out of Mirage Tower and makes it official with that house.
That does tie up the orb score. That puts Maya in a very commanding lead. Not that Maya wasn't already in a pretty commanding lead, but... in this case, it's just even worse.
Yeah, I'd say he's got about a 4 to 5 minute advantage, if I had to take a guess, because you're right. He's got to go back to Sarda and pick up that free item there, and then he's got to go to Gaia to pick up that item. So.
And we can't forget that Groggy Dog already popped his bottle, so he has to even remember that that's even a thing.
Yeah, Maya very quickly going through this thing. And here's the other thing, too. Maya also has a ribbon, and Groggy Dog does not.
That does mean that there are two free ribbons floating out there somewhere, but I don't think anybody's going to go hunting for them.
Oh, gosh, he also has to translate the slab and get that item, too. So, yeah, he's... definitely has a lot of business to attend to first.
And the slab, as we know, leads to Ruby, and the Ruby leads to Thor. So really, this is a gigantic waste of his time.
And Groggy's like, forget it. I'm just gonna go through the Earth Cave and light my third orb here.
I don't know that I can necessarily blame him. I mean, for all the time he's taken, he might just be feeling that he's kind of behind at this point.
Yeah, but he's got to remember to go back to Gaia, pick up the loop, because if he doesn't, if he forgets, he loses.
We got Maya encountering Carrie.
Yes, this should be a very textbook fight. Four hits, 109. Kiki. That's how competitive this fight is. We're repeating what the bats say. Kiki. A lot of four hits for 102, 109, 10-something. Oh, wow. Carrie had Blaze. My goodness.
And then the Black Mage decided to take a nap.
He is out of Fade Charges. I'm gonna put a wall down. Yeah, that's understandable. Four hits for 100.
I think that Carrie actually has all the two spells. Fire 2, Ice 2, and Lit 2.
Yeah. There's the Ice 2. Yeah, just a lot of chipping going on here. Yeah, but he's going to change that with two uses of the Power Gauntlet. That's going to definitely make a difference here.
Groggy Dog taking the time to go have a dance party with the bats.
Well, there's the damage poison. We talked about that earlier. Four hits, 200 damage. That is it. Carrie's gone. And that means that Maya has the orb lead now, if only for a couple minutes.
Groggy Dog paying a visit to Count Chocula over there and raiding his closet for a good 7 grand. I mean, not that's really relevant to anything.
Yeah, well, you never know. It could have been the Massivune, and if it was, and everybody skips that box.
This is why I'm so slow when I run my seeds. I check every box.
Okay, so now the fighter is going to go ahead and learn that Inv2 and exit. And gonna pick up some Pro Rings. I remember Pro Rings being here. Ooze with Flash. That's a very uneventful spell.
Well, that just begs the question, what's it supposed to do?
I think it gives a dark or something. Or are you saying what are the oozes supposed to do? Oh, I don't know. Nuke?
Definitely Flash. Flash is one of those things that I see every now and again, and it makes a screen flash, and that's about the size of it.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's just dark to, I think it's all characters. So it's like, yeah, not too bad. All right, we have a Lich fight over on Groggy Dog's side. 240 damage to start from... Oh, yeah, okay, that was fun. Lich shows up, Lich goes away.
Yeah, Lich living up to his title as a speed bump.
All right, so now the next play from Groggy Dog is quite important here. What will he do? He has translated the slab.
I don't know the map very well, but it almost looks like, yeah, he's going for that bottle. He remembered it. Thank God.
All right.
I am very not used to seeing a black mage sprite running around on the overworld. That is tripping me out just a tiny bit.
Yeah, no, that's not very common to see that. But there's the loot. And that means Groggy Dog's in go mode, so but he's got to scream through this Mirage Tower and Floating Castle.
Because Groggydog does have the potential to go promote. He does have that tail. So he could do that first if he were so inclined. I don't think he will, though.
Well, I think he is going... That is exactly what he's going to do. That was a good call. Good call, Sonny.
Well, I mean, you know, sometimes I can be right even when I'm wrong.
But, I mean, this could be important. I mean, well, I don't see him learning any level 7 or 8 magic because he would have purchased some of that over in Gaia, so...
All the good magic came at the low levels. I can't see any reason to go grab 7 or 8. I can't think of anything that would be there that would be any kind of relevant.
Yeah. MG Weirdo in chat, our tracker, definitely mentioning the knight will get some white magic charges with a few level ups, so it's still important that way.
Yeah, I can definitely see that. Shoot, what were some really relevant low-level spells? Because I'm suddenly drawing a blank.
There was Life, there was Fade, there was Ice 3 in there, Temper was in there.
Cure 4, that's Cure relevant. Cure
4. He's checking these boxes, and I can understand why, because there could be a really awesome weapon or some really awesome armor or ribbon in here, but he's going to come off Snake Eyes, and it's going to cost him some time. Oh, I apologize. Life was White Mage only. White Mage, White Wizard only.
That's unfortunate. Because if there's one spell you definitely want on multiple characters, it's Life.
Uh-oh. It's steak time.
Now, funny thing. I actually kind of wanted to do the same thing Groggy Dog did with his sprites. I was, thinking about replacing my sprites with the what are Final Fantasy 3 sprites, but also the sprites used in the webcomic 8-Bit Theater.
I did not know that. And while we were talking about that, Maya has knocked out the fourth orb, and I think he's gonna head on over to the Temple of Fiends Revisited. Ooh. Groggy gonna check out some boxes.
I can't blame him. I don't think he's got a ribbon yet. If I'm Groggy, I want at least one.
Yeah, that's very true. Let's see if he finds one. He finds an ice sword. And a bunch of money. That isn't going to help him here.
Oh, if only Final Fantasy 1 had the throw ability, you could throw the money at enemies.
Oh, he found the ribbon! Nice.
I've really got to stop doing that.
Understandably, no fair resets out of that three vampire fight as Maya heads over to the Temple of Fiends. Gonna go back 2,000 years in the past and go into the Chaos Shrine. Yes, I did the PSP and the NES version.
So our first entry is at 1 hour, 20 minutes and change. I think it was around 29 seconds. And I say first entry because I've seen some runners have to go in a dozen times before they finally clear it. Because sometimes the bosses aren't really the fiends. It's the stuff between the fiends.
But Sonny, you're commentating. And you've been giving all these commentator blessings all game long. So we now know that Maya's going to just go right through here and win. I'm calling it.
As long as there's not some like unruttable fight like this exact one.
This is so vanilla. Uh Uh-oh, it's
there's
a dance
been a lot
party.
Of vanilla.
Yeah, it's a dance party from Frost Giant. Yeah, it's vanilla because you typically run into this battle around this floor of and they typically are mandatory.
Oh god, G-Medusas, I'm not going to want to see those in Topher.
Yeah, somebody in chat suggesting that the green Medusa floor is coming up. Groggy's still coming up, still doing some fighting here. I haven't been watching the point count, but it's got a quite a bit of points on the line right now. Is he going to check out more boxes? Yes, he's going to check out those four boxes along the way. What's that, Sonny?
To be completely fair, if I know Grimmadoose is coming up at Topher, I definitely want more ribbons. I don't want anything to do with anything those things spit out at me.
Yeah, that's a very, very good point. Also, a very good point is throwing down fades with those three Medusas sitting there with damage poison. 3,000 points right there.
Opal hat and a silver ring, not really paying out for Groggy there.
Well, I mean, it's slightly more experience, but or slightly more defense for the knight, but gonna check out a few more boxes.
There's the encounter of terror right there on Maya's side. The Grimmadoosa's just doing terrible, terrible things.
And it pays off, a ribbon on the top part of the third floor.
So now we know pretty much exactly where all those ribbons are. We know that Groggy's not going to get the third one because he's already been to water. You got the other two, though, right?
Yeah, he did. So if things go south for Maya, Groggy Dog might have the advantage. Although Maya might start his second attempt before Groggy Dog gets a chance to start his first.
Is Maya, like, just constantly resurrecting that ninja as a meat shield?
Yeah, and that's very understandable, too. Also as one to help run, because thieves have a higher run rate, typically.
Oh, I totally understand that part, but just that seems like a waste of life charges.
Well, we're gonna find out right now with Lich, as we have the Mudgoal Sorcerer Mandatory battle over on Groggy's side. Oh, the Quake gets hit on Lich, and Lich is gone. Whew.
That's rare to see, but sometimes you just can rebury the dead.
Alright, so now we're going through the fire floor. The encounter rate slowly increasing as we go through the Temple of Fiends Revisited. As he quickly runs away there, two nachos, there's the cremate over on Groggy's side, and here is the old carry. Or is it the new carry? I don't know. How do you look at it? I don't know.
These are the stronger ones. But at the same time, you'd think if they had 2,000 years to do anything, they'd have gotten stronger from the first encounter, so I'm not sure anymore. Maybe the time travel just makes them weak.
Well, no Something matter, Carrie's gone.
I'm all for trying to explain how things work, but I'm at a loss on that one.
Oh my goodness, Groggy's found Warmech, and he is putting 13,000 experience on the line against Warmech.
Plus a ribbon. Can't forget that ribbon.
Plus a ribbon. That's correct. He picked up one ribbon earlier, but saved that, so that's totally fine, and he's going all offense. And a stop comes out from Warmech, too. Very weak attack so far. 6 hits, 36 damage. Not too good. So it's... what's next?
I feel like maybe this Warmech might be beefy, but not really inclined to do a lot of damage.
gone, terminated. Whoa. Oh my goodness, does he want more with the metal slimes? Oh, by the way, Maya's knight is stoned.
And so is the black wizard.
Oh, wow. Who had that? I didn't notice who had that ability, but it's all white mage or nothing here, and down it goes, and the white mage picks up 17,000 experience. Oof.
That's a lot of experience for one white mage.
The white wizard, actually. Excuse me. That's my fault.
I heard it said once it's all right because it's all white.
8 hits, 54 damage. Not a very strong swing there from the knight against Tiamat.
Wait, is Maya actually grinding on these Sahagans that can inflict stone? Because
no.
This does not seem like a good thing to do. I could have sworn I saw him go back.
I think he just wants to get them taken care of so they don't get stoned. Meanwhile, Tiamat goes down and Groggy Dog now saves his 30,000 experience. Oof.
So hey, you remember those like gatekeeper, definitely not a boss things I was talking about before? I think the Sahagans are it.
Yeah, right? Down to one life charge and one cure four charge. Groggy,
that would make me nervous.
Yeah.
Less than 10 heal pots left. And probably going to go through them all right now.
Yeah, now he has to go against the Kraken. Power Gauntlet to start. A fast and... probably... oh, yeah, wall. Yeah, understandable. Here's the Lit 2 to start from the Kraken. Relatively tame. But that Power Gauntlet will be very helpful. He's going to try to fight right now. What's next as the knight is learning spells over in Groggy's side?
Groggy's going to be joining Maya pretty quick here.
Yeah, 8 hits, 483 damage. Needs another really nice hit there. No, Lit 2's helpful as well. Here we go, Temple of Fiends revisited for Groggy.
Coming in a good 9 minutes after Maya, he's got some ground to make up.
Yeah, but Kraken was not very hard today. Tiamat Part 2 is next.
The big factor here is that Maya is starting to run out of healing. Down to like 3 health pots and very, very few healing spells.
Yeah, it's, excuse me, now it's very, very, very crunch time here. 2 power gauntlets coming down now.
That comment in chat a little bit ago, basically giving voice to my thought of regretting having wasted those life charges on the ninja.
Lock 2 coming down to make Tiamat easier to hit. Reduces evasion. It always works now in this randomizer. Gonna throw down the nuke now. And 8 hits, 429. And Tiamat's gone. Level 27 for the wizard. You got one cure 4 left, and it's been used now. Oh, and a very unlucky pickoff by the rock golems.
Rock Golem's doing terrible, terrible damage to that knight, down to 16 HP, but still gets away. That has to feel bad.
And now the knight is gone. Thanks to worms. Ooh. Okay, he's got some heal twos he can use. He doesn't have any heal magic for the night. Didn't give any level one cure fours. Gotta put the knight in the back row. Oh boy. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
This is gonna be tight, because I think now if Maya wipes out, Groggy Dog is gonna have a severe advantage, because Groggy Dog has a lot more white magic at his disposal.
Well,
and then as I say that, bad things start happening.
Oh, the green Medusas, and I think he got picked off too. Got one chance to run. Oh, and they have stun touch too. Oh, and he gets away. Wow, but anyway, fast on the knight. Lock 2 to improve that hit rate. Inv 2 to hopefully increase that evasion rate. There's the power gauntlet. There's nuclear!
I saw that coming.
And that is going to be it, and Maya has to start over.
Maya, I think, maybe learned his lesson. He's going to go back and pick up Cure 4 for that night.
Yeah, and 4 more green Medusas for Groggy Dog, and there goes another soft potion.
This is definitely going to be a very, very big swing, because Groggy Dog does have all that extra white magic to play around with, and some extra black magic while we're at it, because, hey, red mage, why not?
4 hits, 354 damage from an unfasted knight, and Lynch getting the disrespect.
I think Groggy Dog has a much better idea of not putting Fade on the knight, because at least that way you don't have to split those charges between Fade and Cure 4. You can just use the knight exclusively for some emergency backup healing.
So let me explain to everyone here the implications of this race. The winner will become 4-1 and will go into the play-in race to get into the bracket to the round of 16, and we'll have one race to get into the bracket outright and not have to go through that race. The loser will go 3-2. If that person loses again, then that person will go into the last chance qualifier, where only one person will advance to the massive play-in race afterwards. So the stakes are quite significant here, as Maya has entered the Earth floor once again.
So watching Groggy Dog fight Carry 2, we do see that White Wizard casting Fade. Groggy Dog can be a lot more liberal with those Fade casts because he has so much backup healing. Or rather, I should say, Groggy Dog can get away with being more liberal.
Yeah, we have some people in chat already getting all hyped up for that last chance qualifier. Here we go, Wizards the Hags and Great Sharks, and not fooling around, throwing down those ice threes.
We know something about this encounter has, I believe, Stone Touch. I have no idea if it's the Sharks or the Sahagans. Either way, I'm scared of that particular fight.
Yep. Groggy,
at the same time, Groggy Dog does have 2 ribbons, so Groggy Dog is probably less scared of that.
Yeah, I mean, that's a big thing. That second ribbon, Sonny, is very important.
Is this what they call the seafood party platter, or is that just when it includes snakes?
Well, yeah, we also need some snakes, but I tell you what. We noticed Demarine in chat, and with lobsters having lit 2, I think she's a happy white mage at this point.
Wait a minute, did I just see Lichu's crack?
I did not notice that, but I do see a downed knight, but He's gonna be okay.
I am 97.3% sure I just saw a Lich use crack, which basically means Lich is really tired of getting walked over.
Well, yeah, I mean, that was Lich's sixth loss, so... Yeah, I get it. So... Now we have to address the Kraken. The not-so-powerful Kraken, but we'll see. Looks like Groggy Dog's taking it very seriously. Power Gauntlet, Fast Charge. Whoa, 12 hits, 763 damage. That hurt.
At least it hit the red mage and not the white mage.
Yeah, I mean, so long as the white mage is still alive, still got life charges. And maybe the does the knight have life charges? I'm not 100% sure, but it hits 500 damage.
I don't think that the knight could learn life. Oh, I thought it was white locked.
Oh, yeah, and you know what? I think we talked about that. But no matter, white mage stayed alive, and everybody's coming back alive, and there's some cure fours, and here we go. The air cave, and Maya is not far behind, to be honest.
Maya's seen all this before and knows exactly what encounters to not deal with.
Now, there's an encounter you gotta deal with. Those wizard. Oh, it's the Sahags that have Stone Touch. Oof. That's worse.
Yeah, because there's six of them. So they have plenty of chances to try and inflict that Stone Touch.
Meanwhile, Tiamat. Another round of M2. We got a nuke charge for 194 damage and damage poison. What is with all the damage poison today? 8 hits, 94 damage. That is not going to be helpful, but there's the termination. And Groggy Dog's going to be in really good shape getting into Chaos. But we know that Chaos has Nuclear. Oh, and it's a mandatory Iron Golem!
Yeah, I have trouble with the Rock Golems. Never mind Iron Golems. I never fought one of those. But it looks like this one happened to have been made of paper mache and sticks.
Yeah, well, there's the Rock Golems.
I've got to stop saying things.
All race long, Sonny, all race long. Okay, where's that ribbon gonna go? Okay, it's gonna go with the knight.
That is one wall charge that you don't have to use, at least. What is Groggy Dog doing?
He needed a warm-up lap. Here we go, chaos time! We are going Lock 2, Fast, Invis 2, and the Power Gauntlet. Two hits, 287 damage. Red Mage is in trouble, but gets the Fast off. No problem there. There's the Power Gauntlet. There's the Lock 2. What's the next play? Temper. Cure 4 to try to keep that Red Mage alive. Just 130 damage to that Black Mage. 302 damage to start the bidding here with Luke the Knight. More temper charges. And there's the fade for 276 more. Oof, 8 hits, 524. So there's 1,000 damage down, and that is a slain Black Wizard. Nothing happens from the White Wizard. Another 8 hits, 261 damage, so...
I never
I said
quite
621
understood.
Damage.
I never quite understood the purpose of waiting. The mages could still be like swinging, even if it's just for one damage. One damage can make a huge difference.
Well, the reason is it takes a lot of time to do that thing. But no matter, Chaos is down, and Groggy Dog has won the race with an official SRL time of 100 minutes 59 seconds. Groggy Dog goes to 4-1, and I believe Maya had to start over yet again.
That is really unfortunate. Maya had such an amazing lead for most of that game, but then just wasting all that white magic that was at such a premium really cost him.
Yeah, and it definitely just adds to the call about how the rainbow mage, the red mage, the white mage, and the black wizard, or the black mage, excuse me, always tends to turn out to be the optimal party with these flags. Now we're gonna see what happens when we start getting to the more difficult flags with the chaos flags and the bracket flags, but we will be hearing from Groggy Dog in one moment's time.
Well, in the meantime, we get to watch Maya make every attempt. Oh, there's Groggy Dog. Welcome, Groggy. Very good game, sir.
Thank you so much. I am shaking right now. Wow. Thank you so much.
I keep hearing of runners being very shaky after they win such a big match, and I tell you, this randomizer is so intense. Like, yeah. I mean, I run Dragon Warrior Randomizer, and it's quite a bit slower paced. So I definitely get, and I mean, I get nervous as heck. So I can't imagine what this is like. So congratulations, you are now 4-1.
Thank you.
What are your thoughts? What's your take on this seed?
I genuinely thought when I found Floater in Ice that I lost. In my head, the narrative was already, I gambled hard on Marsh, and then when I chose to chase the TNT and the crystal instead of going to ice, you know, that was another gamble saying, like, okay, I think if Maya didn't go Marsh first and is stuck in Volcano and Ice, then my best chance at really beating him, because I think he's better than me, honestly, is to just like hope that the thing that he needs is now closer to me because I have canal. And so when I went through everything and then found Floater and Ice, I was like, he must have gone there first. He must have gotten the Floater. I just assumed that he would have been way ahead of me. So I genuinely hitting the button and then looking in the chat and seeing that I finished first was a shock.
Yeah, you are. You actually were 9 minutes down entering Temple of Fiends, but Maya only had a white mage and a black mage. You also had your red mage with you, so he very quickly ran out of white wizard charges, and now he's on his third attempt at Topher.
Wow! You know, I want to say this is the third week I was behind going into Topher. And I've somehow won. I do love that. I think those are Final Fantasy XII names on my screen. I like that. Which is just bananas to me. I think the thing that I've drilled into my head over all these practices is how important those early levels are. And just, like, taking your time to grind on the way. And it feels slow and it feels bad pretty much every time. But, like, at a certain point, I'd say that the results speak for themselves. You know, like, I have a much better record than I thought, and I'm really glad that one of the conscious decisions I made through the practice was, like, slow down, grind harder than you think you need to, because it's going to be the thing that separates, and yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. And I mean, you never know, right? I mean, the ice cave could have had anything other than a Floater. But,
yeah.
If it did have anything but a Floater, you would have been well in the lead instead. But
right, I still think it was a good gamble. It was one that very, very clearly did not pay off. But I feel good about the gamble. So yeah, I mean, like, and I think when I realized that the Floater was going to be in Ice Cave, I had sort of like the resignation of just like, yeah, like I did pretty well. You know, there are some things I could have done better, but. This was not a horrible seed for me. I just made one bad choice specifically. But yeah, it feels really good. I feel very happy. It feels, you know, I'm going to be in terrifying company next week, I know. But like I said, Maya's a great runner. This feels a little bit like I've stolen something. But yeah, GG.
Yeah, there is a chance that you will run into a 5-0 runner, unless you've been paired up already. I don't know if you've been paired
I
up
haven't,
already.
no.
You have
I
not.
haven't.
So yeah, it is possible that you will run into possibly Demarine. I know I saw her in chat recently, so
Yeah, she popped into my chat before my race to give me a follow and say hi. So she, yeah, maybe she gave me her luck and is just gonna beat the tar out of me next week. So I don't think I can get away with going into Topher second any more weeks.
You'd said you made one bad gamble, but you made one really good gamble continuing to check those chests in Mirage and Sky, finding ribbons that Maya never
That
found.
was nice. Yeah, I was worried that. Yeah, I think that was a two-part gamble. One part was skipping over Mermaid when I was in quote unquote go mode, but yeah, I got lucky. Sometimes I think, like honestly, I think that was the story for me in the Duck Derby. I think it's been the story for me in here is like being fast enough, being good enough to put myself in the position to be lucky. I think I've gone up against a few runners who are better than me, but just by getting myself in the right position, I've been able to take advantage of some stuff. So, and part of it too, I think, is party comp. I know a lot of people have been wanting to try different stuff. Cheese saw me practicing fighter red or red black black or red black. I can't remember at one point before the tournament started, and it was like, "You gotta stick with fighter rainbow, dude." I was like, "Yeah, it's a good idea," and it served me well in pretty much every seed. I was kind of hoping that Maya had rolled something without a white mage so that I could take advantage of the fade boost at the beginning. But yeah, I think having the fighter rainbow comp, which is just something I feel really comfortable with, has helped. I'm useless for like iron golf flags. I'm useless for floor shuffle, but like these more standard flags, I feel very much like I'm in a groove right now.
A number of people like that. Some people are better at the random flags, and some people are better than at the regular, more standard flags. And here's exhibit one, number one right here. So, definitely a very amazing run. Cheezinator in chat mentioned, and I did want to cover it. Excuse me, I'm losing my voice here. If Elastoid wins, then you might have this pair down situation. Meanwhile, Maya's side, he's down to a knight once again. It's gonna be pretty tough here to knock out Tiamat. We'll see what happens, but gonna give it a go.
So what was the routing that Maya took at the beginning of the game, but right before we get to Tia?
Oh, I'm sorry, what was your question?
What routing did Maya take?
What routing should you take?
So what routing did Maya take like right at the beginning? Did
Oh.
he go straight to Volcano and Ice?
I think he went to Volcano when you went to Marsh or something like that. I think that's how that went. Do you
Yeah,
remember, Sonny?
it went straight to Volcano, skipped over Marsh completely. Maya never set foot in Marsh.
Gotcha.
I do wonder though. What was your reaction seeing the Medusas and Gyromedusas? Because those things seemed pretty scary.
Funnily enough, I'd forgotten about them going back into the Temple of Fiends, and so when I hit them on that just horrible, like maybe the worst earth floor I've ever had, I had that brief moment where I was like, oh no. That is not, fortunately, that is not the worst ordeals I've gotten in this tournament. Hey, good for Maya takes out Tiamat. I think this is a chaos that might be able to be beat by one fighter. But yeah, that was not the worst ordeals that I've had in this tournament. And so at a certain point, it was just kind of like I knew I could get through. It was frustrating, but it is what it is. You were hoping for something a little bit better on that spike tile, and I got rocked pretty hard.
Well, fortunately, going into Topher, you did have the advantage of having those two ribbons, which I think negated a lot of what those Gyromedusas could throw at you. Those Wizahoggins, though, with their stone touch, that had to suck.
Before you answer that, Groggy, I do have to mention that Maya has indeed forfeited after that very unlucky Wiz Vamp Zombie D fight. He was trying to get some evasion, try to get through there, but unfortunately was not able to get by, and Maya will be joining us for an interview shortly. So sorry for the interruption. Go ahead.
Sorry, what was the question again? I totally forgot.
Sorry.
The Wizahogs with their stone touch, that seemed like a pretty scary fight. It seemed like the entirety of Topher was what I was saying earlier in the commentary. There were no actual bosses. There were just the really tough things between the bosses and chaos.
Yeah, I'm glad that I had the accidental foresight to have so much money early in the game that I bought a stack of those softs in Canaria. Because I needed them. Anyway, I used three of them in Topher, so... Yeah, glad I had him. That was probably the grossest, just like random encounter Topher I've ever had. Or Earth Lord sticks out in my mind specifically, but there were a lot of not fun things.
Yeah, the water wasn't too good either with the Wizahogs with stone.
Yeah, that last fight I took right before Kraken, I can't remember what it was. I was just jamming A on my controller, hoping to get out of it because I was so frustrated that I couldn't run.
The Wizahogs were unrunnable with their Gersharks.
There were a few enemies that really surprised me too. They were extremely tanky. The Agamas were really, really tanky too. Like, for a bunch of grinds I wanted to take and just didn't feel good about. That was a fun scene. I always love when you get canoe early, especially when Volcano is incentivized. Just because it, you know, you get so many branching paths that I think it's real fun to see what happens. And so, I feel lucky that the gamble I made paid off, but not too much more to say than that.
All right, we have Maya joining us in the broadcast booth. Good game. That was a tough Topher, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was one to remember. That was not a good one. I had gotten a glance at the 11 hit stun touch Gurmedusas when I was in Sky, so I knew that that was there, but I did not know about the Wizsahag Gershark encounter. That was a complete surprise to me.
Yeah, that surprised all of us. I didn't even know it was mandatory until just now.
Yeah, that was disgusting.
Disgusting registered trademark.
Congratulations.
I know that as our Random Mania calendars come up here, I know that Groggy ran into the Green Medusas at Ordeals. That was the spike tile. Ooh. before the box there at the box. For the slime, I think it was.
I worked out before I saw that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I worked out before I saw that.
I should have worked out before I saw that. Yeah, I cleared the whole thing and then wiped on that and then had to go do it again. I had exit. I was hoping that it was something I was going to like, and it was the exact opposite.
My fun, stupid wipe of the day was I wiped to the double fighter encounter at the end of... Waterfall, because I got greedy and I was like, ooh, I want this experience. And then they were having none of it. So,
yeah. Yeah. I have one near miss with them, I think, where I've been grinding on them a while. And then I figured it was somewhere in Waterfall, maybe, where they took way more out of me than I expected. And I was like, okay, I think this is time to end this fight.
Right. Right. Well, GG's to you. Congratulations.
Now, Maya, so how did you feel having the thief?
Just fine. The thief was pretty useless, to be honest. So thief got flattened, I think, before I went into Ice Cave, I think, is when I finally danned him.
Yeah.
There was not much there as far as black magic went. So I decided to drop the character and... go with three instead.
Yeah. We apparently had a very early route divergence where you went to Volcano and Ice, and mm-hmm. I went to Marsh and found the Loose Canal. And then
that's where it was.
Yeah, Ice was the last incentivized dungeon that I checked. You beat me to Topher. I forget. They said how much, but I can't remember. But you beat me to Topher.
9 minutes.
Yeah, because I just never got the floater until the very end. Like, it took me so dang long to get there. But I had leveled, and I got lucky in finding two ribbons on the second to last sky floor.
If I recall correctly, after I did the inner sea checks and checked some key items, I went and dove down to the bottom of Volcano and then exited back out. And then checked those two items, which, if I recall correctly, ended up being Power Bonk and Opal Bracelet, respectively. And mm-hmm. so I was pretty annoyed at that point. I had not gone to Martian, and I thought, well, there's one more incentive I can check. And so I checked ice. And then that cracked everything open.
Yeah.
But I'm looking at my list, and I found every incentive item there was. So the canal was one, and then which one am I missing? Like, what was the other free item?
Adamant and Topher and...
Right.
Shoot, it was in, was it TNT in Volcano?
Well, that's right. It was TNT and Volcano. And that's armory. The other one. And then, yes. And then Canal would have been the third.
Oh, Crystal and Armory. Thanks, Weirdo.
Right, Crystal. That's it.
Okay. TNT. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Because I made the choice after that. Instead of going to ice, I bailed on the inner sea and went to, or I bailed on Volcano or finished Volcano and then went and turned in those two and got nothing out of it and missed out on ice. So that didn't pay off at all.
What did Chaos have? I got to Chaos once and he flattened me in the first round. So what was in there?
My mind is like already a blur. I was so just like I was shaking in the end of it. Not much. I don't think I lost. Oh no, I did. He whacked my black mage and my red mage there at the end. But I'm forgetting what spells he had. Nothing. I didn't see nuclear.
We know he had nuclear, but.
That's what killed me off.
Oh, he did? Okay. Yeah, lit two, I remember, like Weirdo says in chat. I was not paying attention to what I was doing because I can't even remember. Okay, I didn't see a skill. That makes sense, too. he just slapped my black mage and red mage to death.
Was it finishable with the defense sword? What did you have?
I don't think I ever found the defense. I was just rocking some Invis 2s, Block 2, and Sun.
All right. The defense sword was hanging out in the Sharknado room along with the third ribbon.
Aha! I did very nearly clear that. That's good to know. That would have been a good find, but... I mean, I got lucky finding a lot of the stuff I needed in Sky, so...
That Sky play really helped you out a lot with those two ribbons that were hanging out in Mirage and Sky, right?
Yeah. One was on the first floor of Mirage, and then one was on that final chest floor in Sky. GG's, Matt. That was a hell of a Topher.
GG's to you, too. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, well... We'd like to thank our runners, Maya and Groggy, for a very entertaining race. Definitely enjoyed it very much, and congratulations to both of them on a very entertaining race.
Yeah, thank you all. Thank you all for commentating and tracking.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Thanks very much.
Been a pleasure. And Maya does fall to 3-2, but still at least in the last chance qualifier. But Groggy moves up to 4-1. And is now in the big play-in race. Much higher chance to make it in the brackets. But still got one more race to go. And Groggy might make it to the bracket outright. And Maya might make it into the play-in race. So we're going to find out sometime next week. Chaos Week coming up real soon.
Yeah. That's the luck, Maya.
Thank heavens.
I'll sure be rooting for you.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Thank heavens for Chaos Week. I'm ready for three loose items, please.
Yeah, it's gonna be weird. I'm actually really glad that I'm going 5-1 into Chaos Week, just because, like, mm-hmm. I've been very lucky in the tournament. A little bit more luck might get me an upset, you know, like three. If it's going to happen, it's going to happen on three loose.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, again. Well, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up, and but I do want to thank our runners for the great race, and I also want to thank MG Weirdo, our tracker, and keeping us straight here as far as all the interesting things going on. So well done to MG Weirdo. Really appreciate the help there. Also appreciate the help of Sunny, my co-commentator. Well done. Really, really appreciate your work. Any last thoughts?
I just keep saying it. I have got to stop saying things.
Oh, yeah. We got to bring that up with our runners. But in the meantime, we're going to raid Randomania 2. So for Maya and Groggy, our runners, our tracker, MG Weirdo, my co-commentator, Sunny, this is me, Game Boy F9. You've been watching Randomania 3. Please have a great night.